Hey you guys, it's Cass here with Transform Spaces. This week I want to give you 5 quick tips on decluttering your house before you sell. Oftentimes people move before they declutter and then they end up moving with so much stuff that they didn't even need. Sometimes people even move with garbage. So it's really too bad because in your new home you want to start off with a fresh new start with no clutter, no garbage, and you want to begin new. So here are my 5 quick tips for helping you declutter before you move. So step number 1 is take a tour of your home and look at all the areas that you know you need to begin decluttering. Look at every single closet and drawer and bedroom, every single corner, and write down what are all the spaces that you know you need to declutter. And you may even find some spaces that you haven't looked in a while and realize like, wow, I have a lot more to go through than I thought. It's important to begin the decluttering process as soon as you have an idea about moving, because a year can go by really fast, or even 3 or 6 months can go by really fast. When you thought you had a lot of time to declutter, it's gonna go by faster than you think. So the moment you think about wanting to move, begin the decluttering process. Step number 2 is start decluttering in the area that you know you can declutter the fastest. The reason being is because you want to get this stuff out of your space as fast as you can. So whether it's throwing it in the garbage or donating it or selling it, that way you can feel like you've accomplished something, but also you'll have that much more extra space to work with. Step number 3 is pack as you go. If you know there's some things that you don't need in between now and when you move, put in a box and label it in a way that you know exactly what's in the box, especially if there are photo albums or things that you definitely wouldn't use in between now and then. And then you can even ask yourself, if I'm gonna put it in a box between now and when I move, do I actually need it? Step number 4, or tip number 4, is don't think that you have to do it on your own. Ask for help. So you can ask for help. I help people declutter their homes to move all the time. We get rid of so much stuff and it's so great because it's like a huge weight off of people's backs. So ask for help. That is a big one. Even if you don't want help during the whole process, at least someone helping you, you know, decide which steps to take, where to begin, and where to go after you've accomplished some areas. And tip number 5 is try not to take the task of selling your items on your own. If you know someone locally that can sell your items for you, at least that way you can still make a little bit of money, but you aren't taking up the time investment, which selling your stuff can take a lot of time. So if you can have someone come and pick it up and then they sell it all for you and just give you the cut, then that is so much better. What I realized since working with the clients is when there's a third party person there helping, you get rid of so much more stuff. And in fact, a lot of wives say to me, Cass, how did you get my husband to get rid of all of that stuff? I've been nagging him for years. Well, you see, I am a third party, I come from a third party unbiased perspective. So I really feed off of what people are saying in terms of what they need and don't need. So if I feel like the husband or the wife or the kids are through their body language just saying they don't need it, well, I coach them into getting rid of it. It is so much better to start in your new home on a fresh new slate. So again, you guys, I'm Cass with Transform Spaces, and you can find me on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook at Transform Spaces. Please like this video if you enjoyed it, leave a comment, I always respond, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you again so much for watching, and I hope you have an amazing day. Bye!